After recording my last video, I upgraded to LibreOffice 3.6.1.2. It's always good to use the most current release of LibreOffice, but when I upgraded, it deleted my TFCG line style. I had to recreate that. I also had to recreate the color that I created. Not only was my hatching deleted, but they took out Sun 2, which was the color I used. So I put in my TFCG color instead. On the good side, the toolbar that I created in one of the first videos is still out there and unchanged. Now let's take a look at how styles work, and we're going to do that by clicking on the styles icon found on the line and fill toolbar. The styles dialog box works just like the toolbars, meaning I can drag it away and have it floating, or I can have it anchored to the side. To see what some of these styles look like, we'll want to select at least one shape and one connector, because the shapes and connectors work differently with the different styles. Actually, I'm going to select the entire page by holding down Control and hitting A. We see our handles going around the entire page, the green boxes, showing that we've selected the entire page. Now when I choose a style by double-clicking on it, it affects the entire page. Here we see that yes and no were also updated with an outline and a blue fill area. To choose a different style, let's look at dimension line. Here we see the connectors have arrows on both sides and the area is invisible. First line indent, that's probably one we'd want to use for a text area. And heading the same way, let's skip down to object with arrow. Object with shadow, object without fill, and text. Text looks like what we had for our yes and no originally. Then we also have some titles that really don't work well for us. So we're going to go back to the default. And we want to change our yes and no back to the text style. To do that, we need to deselect everything. So I'm clicking outside of my selection. Now I'm clicking the yes. And text, and now I'm clicking on no and double clicking text, and we've successfully updated the styles. Now let's create our own style. To do that, I'm going to right click inside the style dialog box. If I click up where there are styles, it gives me two options, new and modify. It selects one of the styles and asks me if I want to modify that or if I want to create a new style. If I click down below where there are no styles, I'm just given the option of new. I want to give our new style a name, and I do not want to link this with anything. At this time, we're going to link it with none, and it goes into the custom styles category. I want to change my line style to my created line style. And I want to change the area to the gradient that I created. Now nothing's changed because I haven't assigned my new style to anything yet. So I'm going to select the entire page by holding down Control and hitting A. Now if I double click my style, we see that it affected the entire page. Now that looks pretty good, only we don't have any arrows, and the text is a little bit large. Let's modify this. I want to add my arrows in the line tab and change the font to 18. Now my alignment of the font looks pretty good, but just to make sure, it says left. I'm going to change this to center. Now when I click OK, it's affected right away because these are already assigned the TFCG style. Now let's create another style. I'm going to call this one TFCG Style Blink, and I'm going to link this with the TFCG style. The blink is going to come from text animation. I'm going to change the effect to blink. I'm also going to change the font color to blue. That would be found under font effects. Light blue. Now to see the style in action, I want to assign it to a shape. I'm going to click outside of my selection, and I'm going to select this end of data. Double-clicking the blink style. Now it has my new TFCG style blink assigned to it. Now I've decided that I want to change all the backgrounds to a different color. I don't like the gradient, so I want to change my TFCG style to the color I created. And we see that not only does it change it in the TFCG styles, but also the TFCG style blink. It's updated there because we're telling it to grab the TFCG style, apply that style, and then apply the TFCG style blink and make any other changes. To see that better, if I change all styles to hierarchical, we see that it first applies our TFCG style, then it applies our TFCG style blink. And above, we've got our default style before it assigns any of our other styles. And if we don't remember what exactly was changed in these styles, if I right-click, go up to Modify, and look under the Organizer tab, it tells me what it contains. Here's the ticker flash is what that blink is, and light blue, that is our font that we changed. So we only have those two changes in our TFCG style blink. To complete our flowchart, we want to change our yes and no. I'm going to hold down shift, and it's selecting both the yes and the no, and then I'm going to double click the text and set that back to the text type style. So those are the basics of the LibreOffice Draw styles.